Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.
Hi, my name is Janvi Subramanian, and I'm going to share a few lessons I learned from the book Guru Nanak Dev Ji and few other references. First, let me quote a bani from Sri Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Dehura Masid Soi Puja O Nivaj Oi Man Sape Ikpe Anek Ko Pramao Hai. Which means, God is in the temple and the mosque, in the Hindus' puja and the Muslims' namaz. All humans have one origin. Though they appear different, all have the same form made by God. This is what I learned from the story. No Hindu, no Muslim. Now, how can we apply this to Sikhs in today's world? We should treat all people equally, irrespective of their religions or beliefs, just like the way we do it in the Gurudwara. For instance, me and my family follow Hinduism, but we are still welcomed at our Gurudwara the same way as others. Sikhi is a way of life, not a series of rituals. Remember the three golden teachings of Guruji. Naam Japo, remember God. Kirat Karo, do honest work. Vand Chakho, share with those who have less than you. Let me ask you a question. Can we take money to the next world? No, money cannot be taken to the next world. Then what can we take to the next world? Only our soul, a happy and pure soul. How can we do it in this life? Earn money in the honest way, save some for yourself, and give the rest to others in need. As Guruji said, this way it will give us peace of mind. We will feel happy and complete. So, your soul will be happy and pure to go to the next world. In this book, Nanak Dev Ji taught Bhumiya three lessons. They are, always speak the truth. Do not steal from someone who saw you taste it. Do not rob the poor. The first lesson says, when you speak the truth, your heart will be happy. When you lie, your heart will be happy for a moment, but it will hurt you after some time when you see the effects of the lie. The second lesson says, be loyal to people who feed you. The third lesson says, stealing is bad, but stealing from the poor is worse. If you rob the poor, they lose all their belongings and be very unhappy. So we should be kind and helpful to all, especially those who are less fortunate than us. Guruji also gave us the message of truthful living, and getting rid of ego is truth. First, truthful living. Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, Sacho ore sabko upar sacha achar, which means, truth is the highest virtue. Higher still is true living. How can we lead a true living? Guru Arjan Dev Ji shows us the way. Chitta aave os paar brahma tan man seetal hoy. Which means, let the creator into the heart. Mind and body will be at peace. How can we do it in this life? We can do this by surrendering ourselves to the Holy Guru. Only the prayer which is performed with the mind fully concentrated is accepted at the door of the Lord. Prayers performed only with the body does one no good. Coming back to the second lesson, getting rid of ego is truth. Ego clouds our mind and makes us do wrong things. According to Guru Angad Dev Ji, Home dir grog hai, daru pi ismahi, kippa kare je apni, ta gurka shabd kamai. Which means, following the spiritual laws, hukams, lead one to overcome one's ego, palme. Truth makes our mind clear and happy, so we can erase ego by being truthful in life. Finally, I would like to share my favorite hymn of Guruji, which I learned from my Paiji from my Gurudwara. Guru mere sang sada hai nale, simar simar tis sada samale, harka naam hridayan tyai, sangi sathi sagl tarai. Which means, my guru is always with me near at hand. I cherish him forever by meditating in remembrance of him. Meditate continually on the name of the Lord, and you shall save yourself and your companions. Thank you all. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.